Mr. Vishveshwar Ahuja, Managing Director and CEO of RBL, joins us. Mr. Ahuja, good morning. Thank you for joining us. Now, what has led to a strong NII growth and margin expansion and a strong profit growth for the quarter gone by?
Yeah, a series of outcomes here from in terms of the various aspects of our business. First of all, the main thing is that the top line growth is largely resulting from the fact that all our businesses have shown very strong growth itself. So the wholesale banking businesses, which is the corporate commercial banking business, has grown in excess of 40%, and the financial inclusion, development banking, and retail lending businesses have grown close to 50% per annum, this year over last year. So that has led to an overall 44% growth in advances. That's the first part. At the same time, there has been improvement in margins. Yeah, essentially speaking, the while the overall yields on the portfolio have come down, in line with the interest rate environment, but fortunately our cost of funds has come down a little faster than that, and there has been a net 20-25 basis points improvement in the net margin over this period of time. The third is the mix of businesses. The mix of businesses has improved from the higher yielding, businesses are growing a little faster. Like I said, the retail and the inclusion business, are relatively higher building yielding relative to the wholesale businesses, and their mix in the portfolio, has been increasing, and therefore that has also contributed to the better margins. So that's overall in terms of how the effects are panning out. The cost income ratio has come down significantly, so our revenue growth has been significantly faster than our expense growth, even though expenses have grown 30-32%. But I think, as I've said earlier, average revenue growth has been significantly higher, in excess of 50%, and therefore it has led to a significant improvement in the cost income ratio, and that has also contributed to the significantly improved net income. Credit costs have been contained during this period of time, and they remain at very, very modest levels, and that has therefore not had a negative impact significantly.
Okay. You already detailed about the margin expansion. Your NIMs have expanded at about 3.4 versus 2.8 sequentially. Where do you see the margins by FY17N? And is there further a case for margin expansion because of the recent capital raising and change in business mix as well?
No, I think these are very satisfactory levels for us, given the fact that we are continuing to invest and grow across various segments of our business. Actually this is a very satisfactory level for the time being. As we grow our franchise further, and as over time we derive greater benefits from our scale expansion, operating efficiencies, franchise branding, etc., and improvement in the deposit profile, i.e. CASA, which is also improving. But as all of those effects kick in more and more, we might see, a positive effect. But for the time being, I mean, this is the level at which I am happy, as long as we can continue to grow.
We're seeing gross NPAs inching up, 8-9% quarter on quarter. What sectors have contributed? What is leading to this stress? Will this come off? And what levels do you see asset quality stress being contained at?
So gross NPA was 1.10%. Last quarter it was 1.13%. Okay. So while on a year-on-year basis you have seen some increase in the gross NPA level and in the credit cost number, but I would say that it has already started coming down from the recent peak levels. That's number one. Number two is that part of it is it is very much according to plan, because the higher risk based higher yielding assets, i.e. the retail lending book, was a very, very insignificant or negligible portion earlier, and now is becoming more and more significant. Yeah, in the portfolio. Today it is 16% of my total book. So, which was 2 years ago, it was near zero. So the point I'm making is that there is a certain level of planned NPA in these assets, which is there in the business, and it is there. The only thing, so if I look at it segmentally, my financial inclusion business is less than 0.35% gross NPA. My CIB, which is a large corporate business, is again less than 0.5% NPA. My agri business is less than 0.5% NPA. So it is only, and the retail lending is according to the planned levels of NPA around the 1.25 levels. So the SME book, which is a small percentage, is the only area where we saw some buildup of NPAs in the last, not just in the last 6 months, in the last 12, 18, 24 months. And that is because of a business model issue. We had a certain templated program way of doing business in that space. We have changed that business model. We have tightened it to a more traditional cash flow risk assessed basis of lending. And that has started stabilizing the NPA levels even in this portfolio, and they are steadily coming down. So based on this overall situation, that is why I'm very confident then going forward, and already the effects of that are seen in this quarter, the credit costs and NPA levels are coming down.
Okay. Now, as per your presentation, you've stated that the Vision 2020, where you will see advance book growing at about 30% to 35% on a CAGR basis. You've also stated that the return ratio of about 1.5% by 2020. So what are the drivers which will ensure that you are able to achieve your vision statement?
Yeah, so the ROA improvement has already started kicking in. Even in this quarter, it was 1.02, about 6 to 7 basis points improvement. You know, now, again, as I said, the better asset mix towards higher yielding retail financial inclusion businesses, increasing in their overall mix portfolio, the improvement of CASA over time, you know, and the efficiencies and operating efficiencies kicking in, you know, because of scale benefits, and also higher proportion of non-fund income, which again has been showing an improving trend. All of these things will contribute, and of course, you know, like I said, the credit costs will be contained and improved further. All of them will add to a higher ROA, and obviously leading to then improvement in all other related, you know, financial metrics.
All right, we leave it at that. Thank you so much for taking the time out, and all the best for the quarters ahead as well. That's RBL Bank. They've come out with a good number, and the stock is duly getting rewarded as well, up about 4% in the session. Not surprised at all. Everybody's come out with a good verdict on this one as well. However, just before we get into our next earnings call, I want to talk